Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube, and I've been doing a lot of traveling trying to give you some amazing footage. I guarantee you're going to love this. There's something for everybody. Here's some stuff that you probably have not seen before. Here we see Norfolk Southern, and this was coming through like the New Florence area of Pennsylvania. Now, when I was capturing this on this beautiful fall day, I thought it was a great shot of Norfolk Southern with a mixed freight train. And this is what's interesting about going rail fanning is you never know what you're going to see, especially with mixed freight. Because what surprised me in this mixed freight train was some special cars. Now, these are ballast cars, and they're for Amtrak's own tracks. And so these cars, they are covered, except for one. They do have the solar panel on them because these cars are going to be remotely controlled. They could be done by GPS. It's amazing the technology to drop the ballast on the tracks exactly where the GPS point tells it to. It's really neat. Now, I just got done working on the local with CSX, and we are in Manaka at the Blacks Run signal. I get done and I'll show my conductor how my drone works. And a westbound mixed freight train was coming by. You see my local parked in the background. Now the mixed freight train, it does have intermodal in it, does have some mixed freight. It is passing Kelowna Yard. And really nothing out of the ordinary at first. Pretty cool shot of the center beams that we deal with a lot on the local. But then I noticed something special. We zoomed in and look on the rear of the mixed freight train. What do you see? Passenger cars. Totally unexpected. Now they're unoccupied, just going to their next destination. But this helps with your modeling. You got passenger cars? Yeah, run them in a mixed freight train. They're just going from point A to point B. Now here we're catching the Y-103 yard job. What's been tough lately is having both engines facing the same direction. We do prefer to have the engines back to back. But here, the yard job was pretty much done for the day. They're going to take this one car up to Riverton, the other yard. And it's a beautiful fall day. Look at the color. Now this is Daimler Yard, and I do have a video of it. This is not accessible to the public in any way, shape, or form. So here's the only way you're going to see it. Now, let's go across the river to Duquesne, where the Union Railroad had just got done parking its train. And I wanted to show you some neat footage. These cars, they're brand new ore cars that the Bessemer and Lake Erie bought. But look how old the caboose that is still in service, many decades later. But I thought this was a beautiful shot of the ore train. This one's empty. And behind it is where they store a lot of cars. Now this was the old Duquesne Works. And there's the ramp, used to go to the blast furnace. And they store all these covered coil gons. And how neat is that, seeing all that orange in the fall background? Now, speaking of orange, a lot of orange, a lot of red in this. We are in Homestead, the stacks. Now this used to be the big Homestead Works, and the stacks is one of the few remnants of it. But have you ever seen this view? I guarantee you have it. I was so excited to be able to show you this view. Look at the bricks on the outside compared to the factory brick on the inside. And now you know what it looks like from up top. But also in Homestead is the gantry crane. I love showing these steel mill relics. I have another video in my steel mill series about steel mill relics of Pittsburgh. And this gantry crane And you want to model something like this? Let's get some good detail. Look at that. Now, also in Homestead is a cinder car. It's still there. I don't know why, of all places, for them to put a solar panel is right smack in the middle of the cinder car. I don't get it. I think heads need to roll for this one. But still, seeing a cinder car is a good tribute to the still heritage of Pittsburgh and of this Homestead area. Just move that solar panel out of there. Now, look at this shot. We're back in New Florence. And I had to fly far from where I parked to show you the power plant. This will give you plenty of modeling ideas. And more important is just look how beautiful the mountains of Pennsylvania are in the fall. What an amazing sight. And just for security and safety, I did not go any closer. And look how beautiful the sky looks. Just, if you just love watching railroading, this is a great shot. Now, continuing on to Norfolk Southern Tracks, we are going to head to Irwin. And this is the Irwin Car and Equipment, where they made mining cars. And what an incredible shot seeing these old narrow gauge mining cars. I was really excited to see that there was something back here. This is pretty much inaccessible. But it gives you some modeling ideas. Look at that. It looks like toys, doesn't it? So it's something different, just to give you some ideas for your modeling. You have all those extra wheels, there's a car and equipment place. Alright, well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm going to leave you with this shot of Homestead. This is one of the best railfan locations because you have CSX single track right there and Norfolk Southern, their main line also. This is as close as we get to each other, and it's a great place right here to railfan. And so if you haven't checked out my channel, DJ's Trains, I'm asking you to subscribe. I have almost 300 videos where I have everything from how the railroad works as an engineer for the past 23 years to how to model it. There's plenty of prototype information, track planning, layout building, just so much great stuff. So please subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains, and give this video a thumbs up. This was a lot of work, and I appreciate your viewing. Thanks. Bye-bye.